Welcome to the Grokshop. In this video, I'll show how to deploy Gitea on your Synology Diskstation. In addition, if you run the prepackaged GitLab or the manual GitLab in order to get a more recent version of GitLab, I'll show how to migrate from that. So why not use GitLab? Well, take a look. The resource usage of GitLab is pretty much horrendous. It's based on Ruby, and unfortunately it's a very inefficiently written package. It's beautiful, it looks great, but as you probably know, it can be very slow, uses loads and loads of RAM and a good bit of CPU as well. So for these reasons, I decided I needed to move to something more lightweight as opposed to upgrading my RAM. Of course, you can always upgrade your RAM, but I might save that for later. But for now, I'm just going to fix the root cause of my memory shortage. I have the DS1815 Plus, which comes with 2 gigabytes of RAM. And as you can see, it's getting taxed pretty hard, mainly from GitLab. When it gets like this, you're going to be getting into swap and you'll see your drives thrashing around and everything just pretty much grinds to a halt. So let's get right to it. I'll put all the pertinent links below for you. Flip Switching Monkey is the GitHub we want to hit up. Go there, copy the link. Since Synology doesn't provide a package for Gitea, we'll be building our own. So using the link we just copied, we'll go ahead and clone that repository. Okay, next we're going to hit up the Synology Architecture GitHub. On here we can figure out what the architecture is for our CPU. See, 1815 for me is an Avoton, which is AMD 64 architecture. Should be pretty obvious for you to figure it out from here what your architecture is. And of course, we're building for Linux, so we'll be looking for the Linux AMD 64 latest Gitea. Okay, yeah, go ahead and copy that link and head to your Gitea-SPK folder and do a wget on that binary, get that to the local folder. We're going to create our SPK package around this binary. If you happen to download the wrong binary, it may fail if you get the one for the wrong OS. It may not fail if you get the one for the wrong architecture, but you'll find out when you try to install it on the Synology. It'll fail at that time. Anyway, if you do download the wrong one, remove the old one and then run the create under SPK shell script and you should be good to go. Since I'm doing this on a box separate from my Synology box, I'll just need to make the package available in a folder that I can get to from the browser. Okay, so now we want to open up the Package Center and go to the manual install button, click that. Now just browse to the folder where your package is and select the package we just built. Never hurts to have more logs. Okay, with the install done, you should see your Gitea icon in your packages area. So you can go ahead and click the icon. It should send you to your browser and port 3000, which is the default port. Everything should just fire right up. Now for everything to work right, you need Git server and a database. MariaDB is really the only package databases that Synology supports. So I'll go ahead and try to get this going for you. As you'll see, there are some problems with MariaDB depending on what kind of collation you use. If you're a Postgres fan, I got good news for you. Just keep watching. That's what I'll end up using after I go through this big rigmarole. For an initial MariaDB setup, we need to set the default password. Okay, now strictly optional, you can use phpMyAdmin to connect to the database. I'll use the root account admin password I just created. So now we need to set up a database called Gitea. You'll need to select a collation. I need UTF-8. Now MariaDB and MySQL, the thing about it is UTF-8 is not really UTF-8. To use real UTF-8, we need to use UTF-8 MB4 in the collation. And this is where the problems began. So before going on, I want to point out that Synology supports MariaDB 10 and MariaDB 5. MariaDB 10 is generally better overall, and I would recommend using that if you're going to use MariaDB. And to be clear, you can use MariaDB. It's only really a problem if you use the collation that I was just showing you, and I'll explain that more here in a minute. So even though Synology tends to have sort of outdated packages, definitely go ahead and update whatever packages you are going to be using. So the reason I deployed both MariaDB 5 and MariaDB 10 is because I just wanted to see if this problem existed in both. And go ahead and select which database you want to use with your PHP MyAdmin. I'm going to go ahead and switch over to 10 here and just go right back through the database creation process. Here's the SQL to get the port number for MariaDB. I can see it's 3307. Now we need to create the Gitea user. Okay, back in the browser, if you click on register, it'll take you to the initial configuration data entries. You can set up the database here. Remember, we're on port 3307. MariaDB is a MySQL database type. Be sure to enter in your username and whatever password you set up. In here, you can also set up the site title, repo path, SSH port, HTTP port for the website, and log path, etc. When you're ready, click Install Gitea, and basically it's going to try to set up the database. And here you can see there's a failure. The database settings are invalid. The specified key was too long. Max key length is 767 bytes. So with a little digging, I was able to find out what's going on. If you look at the second paragraph, you're up against a 767 byte limit, and divide by four, if you're using UTF-8 MB4, is 191 characters per field. And apparently that's not enough for Gitea. Now with newer versions of MySQL, 5.7 and higher, and 10.2 and higher for MariaDB, the max has been increased. But unfortunately, Synology does not support the latest. I did open a ticket on this. Maybe they'll be updating their MariaDB version soon, but who knows how long that might take, right? So you may have noticed Synology does not have a Postgres package. The reason for that is they use Postgres for their own system, but there's a way around that, and that's to use Docker. If you use the manual GitLab, you may have already Played around with this some. Now the Synology GitLab package will run against MariaDB, whereas the manual GitLab will typically run against Postgres in a Docker. So here you can see I have the manual GitLab package all set up. It runs GitLab, Postgres, and Redis all inside Dockers. Now, if you watch the resource monitor when I turn GitLab off, you'll see huge drops in the amount of RAM and CPU used. So now if you want to run Postgres in Docker, you need to make sure you don't conflict with Postgres outside of the Docker. And mainly you want to make sure you have separate ports. Here you can see the built-in Postgres is on port 5432 and it's Postgres 9.3.22. So the manual GitLab is set up with a composer YAML file. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to just CD into the folder where that composer file is and manually edit that to remove GitLab and Redis and leave the Postgres behind. So here you can see the before and the after. The DB username and password are all masked out. Now I'll force Docker to re-inhale that YAML. Now you can see only the Postgres Docker is running now. Note the port map which follows the YAML config. Here you can see with the Redis and GitLab containers removed, even though I have MariaDB still going, it's looking a little better already. We can get to the Postgres command line like so. And just a quick check of the version here. Shows it's a 9.6.1. The Linux box I'm running here is Debian 8, our Jesse, and pgadmin 4 doesn't install on that distro release. So install pgadmin 3, an updated version, which will talk to this version of Postgres. Of course, you don't need pgadmin. You can do it all from the command line if you want. It's just nice to have that tool available. Now we'll go ahead and set up the Gitea user and database in the containerized version of Postgres. Connecting in pgadmin, we can see the new database as well as the old GitLab database. And notice that there's no tables yet in the Gitea database, whereas, of course, the tables from the GitLab database are there. So the way Postgres does collation is a little different from MariaDB. It's actually based on the operating system that you're in this case, the Docker container, and there's no languages set up, right? There's no locale set up right now to collate against. You can just see it's defaulted to C, which is the ANSI C standard byte order collation, which is fine for me for now. Now in Postgres, when you say UTF-8, it's really UTF-8. It's not like MariaDB. But you do need to set the collation up when the DB is initted. In this case, it was already initted. So you could always export, re-init the DB, and then import your database if you want to change the default collation. Or you can just do your collation on per query basis after you have your locale set up and your collations set up against those locales. So notice I set the port up on the web page per the port mapping I set in the YAML file, 5433. And now we can just plug in our password for the Gitea user in the database. And after clicking the button, finally, no more errors and the tables are all built out. So now I'll go ahead and register a new account in Gitea. Then I'll just sign in with that same account. The first account that you register is by default the admin account. Of course, you can upgrade other accounts to admin status after that. And it looks like our resource needs are staying nice and low. Now, I don't know how y'all roll, but I like to do SSH when I do git. So I'm just going to go grab a key that I already have in my .ssh folder, and I'm going to put that key into the manage key area. So I'm going to go ahead and set up my repository labels. These are repositories, of course, that exist on my local machine. I just need to set up a label and basically a container to push the repository into. This is a website that I built for my wife, and it's called Good Morning Vietnam. And we'll see how we can get this set up here. If you're going to be creating a new local repository, you can use these commands that they give you. Of course, since mine exists already, they won't really be all that useful. And you can take the URL that they give you and run the git remote set URL origin, giving it the URL that they provide there. And that will set it up in your git file. But since I'll be using SSH, that's not really the right format for me anyway. So I'm going to go in and edit my git config here and manually change it to the SSH format like so. You do need to edit the app.ini, which is in this path shown here, to contain the right SSH config parameters like the port, the server, start SSH server to true, and the listen port, and the domain. Set them all up like so. Once you've got all those set up, you can just restart the Gitea server. After the server restarts, you should be able to do a push, and your repository should show up in the server on the browser now, like so. And resources nice and light. That's how it's done. Thanks for watching.